So, as I was saying, Vlad.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so when Paranormal Busters was a kid, I was living up there in one of those houses. I'll show you a picture of it. Now, after school, I snuck on down here to go play with my new friend. All my friends were boys. When Paranormal Busters was a kid, and I was a kid, I had all my friends were boys. This was the first girl, a little girl, who became my friend, and I was a kid. So this is just a story of my childhood. Nothing more. So this was her house, right? She's using Google Earth here.
Hi.
Technology is amazing. This is where, inside her house, where she had her funeral. Strange enough, there's an image captured by Google Earth of someone's face here. It's pretty big. I would not say it's her. Is this her? No, it's someone bigger. There's definitely a ghost that got captured on Google Earth. Right above her door. This could be her mom.
Keep.
Her grandmother. There's definitely a ghost that got captured here. But inside here is where she had her funeral. Her little body was laid out in here. The windows were open. We kids were in there around her. We were the pallbearers. We were the pallbearers at her funeral. Before she died, what I seen was definitely not normal. Now she just became my new little friend, right? So I came down here. This is before the funeral. Before she died, she was alive.
Derek.
I think she was alive. I had just finished school, which is up here, so I decided to come down here to come play with her before I went home. So I snuck on down here, and I said, Marta, Marta. Her name was Marta. And I called out for her, and she said, I'm here. And I said, where? So you see this wall here. Kids are about half this. This is like really tall for kids, right? So when I was a kid, I called out. So this was really tall to me, right? So I called out for her, Marta, Marta, where
projection.
Are you? It was around, not sunny like this, it was a bit grayish skied. And then I called out to her, and she said, I'm over here. So I came around the corner, nothing. And I said, where are you, Marta, where are you? I looked this way, I looked that way. And then she was sitting up here. And I said, oh, how'd you get up there? She says, go around and climb. So I went around, I climbed. And then I sat here. So I'm facing this way. She's facing that way.
Deborah.
And then she started to talk to me. I can't remember half the stuff she said. I was just a young boy and she was a young girl. And I was just enamored by my new friend. Wow. A girl's actually talking to me. And I'm a boy and she's a girl. And you know how childhood is. You have your own childhood stories. But she held my hands. Right here. She held my hands.
Right.
Get a little bit closer. So she kept talking and talking about a whole bunch of things. I don't remember half the stuff she said. Just remember one specific thing, a couple specific things she said. So right here, she was sitting here facing me. So her legs are here, you know, like horsey style. Her legs here, my legs here, her legs here. I'm facing her, she's facing me.
William.
Right? Very gothic scene, right? So it's kind of evening, darkish. So she's here, she's holding my hands, I'm here. She grabbed my hands.
React.
And She stared me right in the eyes. And then she said a whole bunch of things, and I don't remember. And she, what did she say? She said to me, see if I can. I can't remember half the stuff she said, but basically she said, I'm going to be your husband. And I said, oh, yeah? And she said, yeah. And I said, when's this? And she said, when we
Night.
grow, she said, when we grow up. And I said, okay. So she pulled me in with her hands, right? With my hands, by my hands, pulled me in for a kiss, right? Kids do have crushes and such, blah, blah, blah. LOL. But she pulled me in for a kiss, and as I got my face that close to her, I noticed there was blood,
Like,
I repeat, blood coming, dripping down her eyes. Let me show you a picture of her. I do have pictures of her. These are my communion pictures with her. See, turn on the light here.
fig.
You see her there? So that was me. And that was her. So we were over there.
Easy.
See her? That is Marta. That's Paranormal Busters, and that's Marta. Focusing on her face here. That was me. That was Paranormal.
Race.
And we were here. Sorry, the lighting's not doing justice. Okay, now you see that? All right, so she was there. I was facing that direction. She was facing the
Great.
opposite direction. So she's here and there. Now she's pulling me in for a kiss. There's blood dripping down her eye.
Was this video made specifically for kids, or was it not made specifically for kids?
Come to me, Arthur. Leave these others and come to me. My arms are hungry for you, my darling. Kiss me and caress me, my darling husband, please.
And I got scared. But she still pulled me in for a kiss. And then I kissed her. She kissed me on the lips. I kissed her on the lips. That's what, you know, kids
Fear.
with crushes do. And then, me show you a picture. And when were you young? Paranormal Busters. And here's Martina. This is Marta. So that was her.
Spin.
She was here, and I was here. That was her. There's a really tragic story about her dad, this little young one. They were poor, very poor.
Sacrilege.
That's for another video. This is Martina. So blood was dripping from her eyes. And then she pulled me in and she kissed me on the lips, right? Cute, right?
Do.
Cute for kids to do, right? That's just how it is in Europe. What you guys go through as teenagers here in Europe, we develop and do things earlier. That's all I'm going to say about that. Anyway, she pulled me in. There was blood in her eyes. That frightened me as a kid. I was like, what? But she pulled me in. It was quick. She gave me a you know, quick little
important
peck on the lips there. And there was blood dripping from her mouth. And I tasted her blood.
Umbris in Lucha! I bring you from shadow into light. I cast you out the pit.
All right. And then I freaked out because I touched my lips and I'm like, there's blood on my lips now. So I got scared of her.
She Winter.
She kept staring at me. And I said, okay, Marta, I'm going home, okay? She says, okay. Bye. And then I went over here, I stepped down, and I went back home, right? So the rest of the story.
9.
The rest of the story is in this video.
Rocket.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, you're hearing the spirit voice, ghost app, speaking as I'm filming. So, when Paranormal Busters was a kid, after my little friend passed away, Marta, her funeral, I can't remember where in this, it's a huge cemetery, it goes all the way around, there's all kinds of gothic, like in here, there's,
Dan.
Each little house has a whole bunch of people buried. Like, people get buried on top of people. Once their bones, after a few years, after their bones decayed, they're put in catacombs. So there's hundreds of thousands of peoples in here. All bones.
Foliage.
I remember as kids, we'd sneak and we would open the graves and jump in with all the bones and go playing in these tombs where all the bones were. That's where Paranormal Busters first learned about death. Human death, that is. Animal death.
Ben.
You know, how do kids learn about... You know, you see a dead bird and you're like, oh, things die. But when Martina had her funeral here, so all the kids are here. All the grown-ups are here. And somewhere... This is just an example, but somewhere...
Lagoon.
Somewhere in the cemetery. It could be on the other side. As they were burying her body, I remember there used to be more houses of these on this side, actually. So it was like houses. These are all burial houses. And so this is where they keep all the graves. Her casket was open, right? And her mother was wanting to... It was a very dark day, I remember that. Her mother was wanting to see her one last time. She kept crying and crying. And then in front of us, her mother pulled her out of the grave. Her coffin was already in the grave. Pulled her out of the grave, which we kids started to scream in fear. We were like, oh my God. We started to scream. And then I remember being horrified. And I looked at my friend Marta as her dead face is looking at me.
Sense.
While her mother's holding her. And her dead body is just flayed. Just lifeless. As her dead body... And her eyes are staring right at me. And even more blood came out of her eyes and mouth. And we all freaked out. Like, everyone in the funeral freaked out. All the kids started running. Like, I remember I ran. Like, I just ran. I stayed there for a bit. And then...
Something.
Yeah, everyone took off. Like, she stayed there. And she cried and she cried. That's where I remember of the whole funeral. And then I went back home. But yeah. That was my little friend Marta. And I find it very strange. Very strange. Now, what I forgot to tell you guys is this. When little Marta kissed me on the mouth that day, she had already been dead.
Years.
That's what I forgot to tell you guys. That's why I never forgot it. So. That's my story, and it's truthful. Let's roam around with Google Earth on the cemetery here. A lot has changed since then. I am not going to tell you the coordinates of the cemetery.
Separate.
Clear up Google Earth. Technology is amazing. See in here, for the people that can't afford proper graves, there's a little, let's see if I can get it. Better shot of this. The people's pictures are kept there.
Feeling.
See that? The little cover, it's like a metal hat so that the sunshine doesn't burn away the pictures. Right? But the cemetery changes all the time.
Angles.
Hear the spirits describing it. There's even people buried up here too. In here's thousands of bones. We kids used to sneak, and we'd open up the secret latches, and we'd sneak in. We'd play inside the cemetery with all the bones.
Darkness.
Like, when Paranormal Busters grew up, I grew up sneaking around cemeteries and such. Can we go up here? Why can't we go up here? Come on, Google Earth.
Cry.
Anyway, there's many stories in the cemetery. Many. But that's just one of the stories.
I cast you out, the Prince of Darkness, into hell!
For some strange reason, Google Earth is not letting me go up here. Come on. Where's the arrow? Go up. Yes, up.
February.
Up. Yep, please. Alright. This is the back of the cemetery. This is the church, where they have the, some people, like, they have a little ceremony at the cemetery.
Why?
Back of the church. Over here is where they prepared bodies here. Like, right here. See right here?
Radical.
They would put the body there, prepare it with the coffin back in the day, and then they would bring it out over here. So everything was done right there. You know, autopsies and whatnot? Back then it wasn't quite like that. Yes, there was hospitals and such, but they were still prepped for their final burial.
Breakfast.
And that little spot there. These are fresh graves here. What is in here?
Rates.
Yeah, so for the ghosts that live in this cemetery, that visit this cemetery, the ghosts that are there, this is their view. This is what they see. It's beautiful.
Here.
closer. And I'll call you when the party's over. Quiet and I'm coming home and I'm on my own.
Hombres in lucha! I bring you from shadow into light. I cast you out, the Prince of Darkness!
This was her house, right? She's using Google Earth here.
Ty.
Technology's amazing. This is where, inside her house, where she had her funeral. Strange enough, there's an image captured by Google Earth of someone's face here. It's pretty big. I would not say it's her. Definitely a ghost that got captured on Google Earth, right above her door. This could be her mom.
Keep.
As I'm filming. So when Paranormal Busters was a kid, after my little friend passed away, thank you.
used to be a whole lot more things.
Surprise.
They keep changing these things up. There used to be a lot more beautiful little houses here for everyone. And I can keep... Too bad Google Earth doesn't let me jump into the cemetery so I can see this. I can show you the
entire, Norman.
Show you the entire cemetery. I can only show you the panorama. But yeah, I find it strange. I mean, wouldn't you find it strange that... Imagine you were a kid. Imagine you were young and your little friend kisses you on the mouth. There's blood in her eyes, dripping from her eyes. There's blood dripping from her lips. You tasted that blood.
November.
Right? And then you find out the next day that your friend was already dead. So how was it that this person was there? They were already dead.
Rhonda.
Should you let your kids dress up as Dracula for Halloween now? I think that changes your point of view on Dracula, huh?
Drink.
Drink.
The myth of the vampire personified.
I am Dracula.
The visual.
See what he represents? That's what Mr. Blood Drinker
Malice
Blood the Impaler actually represents. But there's a very good man who came and wiped out all that evil.
Grandfather.
The Dracula evil. He took the reality of Dracula and the horrible things he did. Human horrible atrocities he did. And to answer that man's question, yes, Vlad Will is in hell.
Kelly.
Worse than the fate of hell, actually. Damned to live forever and suffer. See, how is that possible? To God, all things are possible. Read the Bible. There are worse fates than hell. So why am I at these castle walls
printed
here? These modern day castle walls. Why am I here? To tell you about Vlad. But before we do that, a little story. When Paranormal
Boy.
Busters was a young man, I don't know, like 17, 18, something like that. It was winter, just like it is now, and mice, like some of you have pests like scorpions in LA, Los Angeles. in this country, our pests are mice, field mice. They like to crawl into cars at night for warmth, into people's houses. They can be quite a nuisance. How do people get rid of those mice? They kill them. Now, when will the animal rights people, PETA, go after YouTube for animal rights abuses or talking about animals being crushed or hurt? There's many videos
Dan.
Like that. There's many videos trapping mice. Poor little creatures, what did they do? Got killed just to make a video? Just for a few views? Right? Now, when I was a young lad, we had a problem, like 4 or 5 mice or so, that we captured, because they were crawling around in the house, in the kitchen. You don't want that, because they can bring disease. You remember the Black Plague?
12.
Yeah, mice can bring diseases. They're very tiny and cute. I'm not talking about rats, the big ones. I'm talking about mice, the very tiny, cute ones. They're cute looking, right? Can they bring disease? It's a non-
Again.
I don't know. Maybe it's just a black myth, black plague conspiracy. How many people in the Middle Ages did the Black Plague wipe out? Lots, right? Because of mice and cats.
Words.
Black cats were eating the mice that had the disease. You see how this all tied in? to the witches and all that. This was all from real things, just like Dracula, the vampire, the bat, right? So we had a mouse problem in our house, and I was the one getting blamed for it in the house. It must be you that's leaving out food and breaking things and blah, 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 right? It's you that's doing it. So, I don't mind. I mean, many people blame me on videos. It's you, blah, blah, blah. But I'm actually trying to fix things. So how did I fix my mouse problem? Speaking of Vlad, why the fuck is there blood on my window? There's red blood there. Maybe I hit a insect or a bird hit my car when flying. I don't know. There's fucking blood in my window. That's fucked. Being a paranormal investigator, you know what happens? There's people in other cultures that will leave like orange peels outside on the floor in my car. Or orange peels. Because they think I bring bad spirits around. So they try to exorcise my car. In this case, someone put blood on my car. I don't know if you can see it. There's little red spots there. Fucking fantastic. Anyway, fucking freaks.
Send.
Anyway. So there's a lot of witchery dudes nowadays. And people who want to be vampires and go to vampire clubs and stuff. I went through a phase like that when I was younger. But now that you know the true story of Vlad the Vampire, Dracula, I don't think you should like him anymore, should you?
Task.
So here's my little story of the mice. Oh, is it okay to let your kids dress as Dracula, since he represents all that carnage for Halloween? Should your kids are adults, right? Should kids dress as Dracula, since he represents such violent acts? Kids don't know that. They don't teach them in school. I think they might teach them that. Actually, they do teach some of the history of Dracula in school. For flip sakes. Not things kids should know about. Vlad the Impaler should not be taught in school. Impaling should not be taught. That's why in the Bible it says after the end of everything, right? The new generations, when Jesus comes to earth, like he takes over the governments and stuff. When Jesus coming back at the second time, didn't you know, like, still, there's still going to be, like, governments and paying your taxes and stuff.
Burning.
What? Yeah. It's just going to be a new king in town, new sheriff in town, Jesus himself. That's when Jesus comes back to earth. Imagine, you turn around, and it's not the police, it's angels going, what are you doing, sir? What are you doing, ma'am? Uh-huh.
Shaken.
Anyway, you guys don't read the Bible enough to understand this. So let's talk about Dracula. Speaking of blood, and Dracula drinks blood, right? Isn't it strange that in church, they ask you to drink the blood of Jesus? I'm just going to let you think about that.
Sober.
For a little bit. Maybe you are a vampire after all. Are you a born again Christian? Then maybe you are a vampire. Because you need to drink blood every Sunday. Or is it every Saturday? What's the seventh day?
Dives.
You guys drink blood on. Nothing against Jesus. I'm a born-again Christian myself. Now, why would God do that? When a person becomes born again, God literally changes their DNA pattern in their soul. You literally become a new creature. Your soul is literally like a new creation. Think of it as God's recycling plant.
Cupcake.
Right inside the human body, the soul. And for a Christian to survive, it needs blood. See, that, what? Ask any Catholic priest, do you need the blood of Jesus? Do you need to drink the blood of Jesus?
Crowd.
They're going to say yes, or else you're not going to heaven. Ask any Christian. You turn right around and tell them, then you're a vampire. You're a vampire. That's what you are.
Wheels.
That's just a small joke. You can't make jokes of holy things. What happens is, although it's wine and grape juice, right? Once it goes down your throat, God supernaturally turns it into real blood. Not just normal blood, but what the blood needs to survive. The every vitamin, that the blood needs for the human body. That's what it is. It's supernatural. Paranormal. Paranormal? No, supernatural.
Puddle.
So we are... Let's go back now that you guys know that. You should read the Bible. And don't forget to go to church and drink some blood. Hmm? How are you, vampires? Anyway. Yeah. It's okay to laugh when you're alive and being happy and making jokes. God doesn't mind these things. As long as you're not blaspheming. As long as you're not talking dirty jokes against God and his processes. Unless you understand. Science doesn't want to have a real look at it. What did God do to make a person born again? Let's do some biological tests. What's going on? They don't even know what the soul is made out of. Why would people, you know, does the wine and the grape juice that they... Some of you are very religious, like Muslims. Can't drink blood. They when they slaughter animals, they don't drink blood. Halal, right? Or the Jews, they won't eat certain meats. Like, it's got to be kosher. Christians, they try to avoid meats that has blood. Or that was sacrificed to an idol, right? That kind of thing.
Spoon.
It's all frequencies. And by the way, I know how to turn water into blood. Water into wine, like Jesus did. Say, how do you do that? A scientific process.
Data.
All you need is a grill, a stove grill, and water. I'm not going to show you how to do it. I'm just going to give you a clue. And the stove does not need to be on.
Script.
But that's science, super science that you guys don't know. And I'm going to keep it that way. I'm not going to show you how. What? Jesus actually turned water into wine? Yeah, science has proof that it's true. Thing is, Jesus never had a stove, so how is he doing it? Frequencies. Prayer.
Kathy.
Okay, so let's go back to our mice story. When I was a young lad, the house got infested by 4 or 5 mice. Every night they would come and raid the cereal, come and raid our food. So, family started catching them one by one.
Behind.
I got tired of being accused of it, right? That it, you know, it must be all your paranormal equipment that's making all these mice show up. It must be all your electronics is attracting the mice. Meanwhile, it's the cold outside. Let's make the mice find a way in the house. Right. So how did I got so mad of being accused when I was like 17 or so. Got so angry. It was like morning time.
Faster.
I finally caught one of those little bastards, one of those little mice. But I'm like, oh my gosh, you know, I literally caught it. It was in the corner with a cloth, and then I caught it, and I had it in my hand. It was so cute, and I opened my hand. It did not jump away with fear, but I had one instinct. We have a reptilian instinct in our brain, right? It's like 1, 2, 3 seconds. It's actually, if you study that, it's in our brain, the pineal gland. There's this other gland that causes our reactions, yes or no, left and right, flight or flight, that kind of thing, right? Designed by God for us to react. So I had the little mouse in my hand. It had my trust. Then I noticed it was going to squirm. I squished it, right? It was still alive, squirming in my hand. Like, I got to kill this little guy. Because if these little mice, you know, everyone else kill them in mouse traps and whatever, everyone does that.
Always.
Right? But I had him in my hand. How do I kill him? I put him outside the porch, opened the porch door, put him outside, was still holding him so you could still see its little head. I grabbed a hammer, put on goggles, because I knew his blood was going to splash, and I hit him with the hammer. The mouse was dead. Now, I've never forgotten that mouse, and I ever regret killing that little mouse. So you've never killed a field mouse before? With a mouse trap that you left on your garage or something? Come on, there. Buddy, did you enjoy your McDonald's? You know how many cows died for you to eat those McDonald's? The pain those animals went
Charles.
Through to make your nice lasagna there? Huh? So, I'm talking about a field mouse, alright? The home mouse, field mouse. So I killed him. I've never killed any little creatures ever since. Little mice. I try to avoid killing little insects. I'll rescue them. What made my conscience so guilty? It's how I did it. I had it, and I befriended it. and it trusted me. It trusted me. Then I hit it with a hammer. That is very, very evil. So what I'm trying to say is what we young kids watch when we grow up and as our brain is developing, some of you are like, why did that person kill that person? Why did that person murder their family and stuff? What were they watching? Your content? You see why the FTC and COP is so important? Young kids do not need to be seeing some of your videos or your messages. You may be causing harm unawares. Do you understand? Now, let's go back to Vlad Dracula and his life story. What made Vlad Dracula start impaling people? Let me show you.
Office.
So, never harm animals, because they say once you start harming animals, it gets to bigger things. But when you're a victim of that shit, that's what happens. Who sent the FTC after all of you? And COPPA after every and single one of you? Well, this little old mouse.
Listen.
Ha, 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 ha